decided the 21st. That is correct. Good job. That's actually very good. I've never made anybody get that right. That's, wow. Okay. Which string of schedules is part of track three? All rear. And what? Was a red here at the
Good morning, Chief.
Welcome to the building.
Thank you very much.
I'll be right back.
Okay, listen. John's in his email, and this is his home phone number.
Okay, that he sent it to me too.
Oh, he did. Uh-huh. He said it would probably be better.
No. I don't know. That's not the one I have.
For a home phone number?
Yeah, because look, he says, "Are you going to call me on my cell?" And then he says, "My home number is." He gave me this.
Well, that'd have to be, right? Because this is 678.
That's the same.
Hey, Miss Hesley.
Good morning, Dr. Right, so that's the same number, so we'll use that.
Good morning. I'm good.
Do you want to be here or on the other end?
Good morning, Mr. Smith. I'm not sure yet. I haven't landed.
The table's kind of reversed today.
Different table?
No, same table.
Okay.
Good morning, Miss Mary.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good morning, Terry Smith.
Rodney, Pirkle, please.
Good to see you. How are you? Good morning.
Did you have
that?
Good morning,
Lisa.
How are you?
I do.
Lisa Williams.
Okay, Lisa, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, Chief.
Blanchard, it's Charity Clark and the Civil Service Board. How are you?
I'm just fine. How's everybody down there?
We're doing great.
Okay, great. Sounds good. Good to hear your voice.
You too. We haven't started the meeting, but we were going to go ahead and give you a call, and I've got you on speakerphone, but we will be starting momentarily.
Alrighty.
Okay, thanks.
Hey, John.
Hey, hello.
Can you hear us good?
Yes, I can.
You're fine, John.
You sound strong.
Oh, we're hanging in there, doing a lot of work. Trying to get this place shipshape, all that stuff, and all the changes that Linda wants done.
Is it snowing up there yet?
No, not quite. I hope it don't. For a long time. Because we're not quite ready to move the furniture stuff in, because I want to get out of here when it starts snowing.
I understand.
Other than that, it's going pretty good. How's everything down there?
Beautiful weather. Finally, we got some break in the heat. It's beautiful.
Oh, yeah. It's been hot up here, and it's just now kind of started cooling down. They finally got a lot of rain up here, and they've been in a drought situation.
I guess y'all got that hurricane, didn't you?
We got part of it, the rain, but it kind of went south of us, so we didn't get too much. It kind of went a little south and north and east of us. Hmm. It dumped too much on us.
Just down here.
Dr. Howe there?
Here.
Oh, how you doing?
I'm fine, sir. How you doing?
I'm doing great. Good to hear your voice.
Thank you, sir.
For those of y'all that are here, John Blanchard is a former member. He just resigned from the board. And we're going to do a little something special for him after a while at the end of the meeting. And that's why he's on the speakerphone. He will not be participating in the meeting, but he will be listening to it. So. We'll give Mr. Miles another minute. Say hello to Mr. Blanchard, Mr. Miles.
Hello, Mr. Blanchard.
Hello, Mr. Miles. How you doing?
I'm doing well, thank you, sir.
All right, good to hear.
Paper's on their way in, but we can go ahead. And here she is.
Good morning.
Okay, we'll call the meeting to order. It's about 10:01 on September the 13th, 2012. We're meeting at the Forsyth County Public Safety Complex on Setting Down Road in Cumming, Georgia. Members present, Mr. Tim Peary, our alternate member, our vice chairman. Mr. Dr. A.Y. Howell, our clerk, Ms. Charity Clark, the chairman, Terry Smith, and our hearing officer, Mr. Dana Miles, and we welcome all of those that are here joining us today, and our assistant clerk, Ms. Amber Watson. We're glad to have you on. Okay, meeting's called to order. Do I hear a motion to adopt the revised agenda? We have revised it from what was posted.
I so move.
Second.
All those in favor of the motion to adopt the agenda as revised, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. The motion passes unanimously. Gentlemen, we have three sets of minutes that we need to approve, and we'll start with the first one, the oldest one. Have you had a chance to read the minutes of the meeting of August the 9th, 2012? Are there any additions or corrections to those minutes? Do I hear a motion that they be approved as written?
I so move.
I'll second it. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those are approved. The meeting of August the 16th, 2012. I hear, did you have a chance to read those?
I move to accept those.
I'll second that motion. All those in favor of the minutes being approved on, of the meeting of August 16th, say aye.
Aye.
It's unanimous. And the call meeting on August the 23rd, have you had a chance to read those minutes?
I have, Mr. Chairman, I have a motion.
Okay, and I second that motion. All in favor of adopting the minutes for August 23rd meeting, say aye.
Aye.
Aye, it's unanimous. We'll move into item four, items for consideration and discussion. Mr. Miles, do you want to give us any update on the John Gooch appeal?
No update. Mr. Yeah. Chairman, nothing has happened at the Superior Court level. That writ of cert is still pending.
Okay. Number two, settlement and release agreement for Jeff Chance, Planning and Development Officer. Do you have any comments on that?
Yes, sir. We have received copies of both the final dismissal and of the settlement of relief and release that has been executed by both the county and Mr. Chance. I would request that those be put into the board records and that we accept both the settlement and recognize the dismissal of the case, you know, in our minutes. I believe Ms. Clark and Ms. Watson have copies of those actual documents because they were the ones that were kind enough to forward them to me. So I think it would be appropriate for us to just recognize that that settlement has occurred and it will be so reflected in our minutes. So that closes the matter out as far as the board is concerned.
We need a motion on that?
Yes, sir.
Do I hear a motion to put the final settlement of the Jeff Chance affair in their records and that'll be the end of it?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I make that motion.
Second.
Motion and a second to accept the settlement and release agreement and put it in our records, which will end the Jeff Chance affair. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried unanimously. Ms. Clark, you want to give us an update on Lorne Twiner's appointment?
Mr. Chairman, I submitted a request to the Board of Ethics-Clerk, Kathy Eccles, requesting that Lorne Twiner be appointed for another term to the Board of Ethics. I have not seen anything appear on the agenda. I do know that I believe they've done the first reading of the ethics ordinance, but beyond that, I have not seen where it's been placed on the agenda to be before the Board of Commissioners for appointment. So at this time, he will continue to serve his term until he's reappointed.
Do you have a status update of what the commissioners have done in regards with the ethics committee? Are they still debating, or are they taking it to a public hearing, or what's?
It's public hearing. I believe they've had the first reading of the public hearing.
And there will be outside members on that board.
I believe that's the proposal. Yes.
Okay, dokie. Let's see. Could you also, Ms. Clark, give us an update on the employee election of the representative to the Civil Service Board.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, when I presented some items before the Board of Commissioners on behalf of the Civil Service Board at a work session, one of the commissioners had raised some concerns about the prior election for the employee representative and requested that Pat Carson, the Director of Personnel Services, look into a process for the election. Myself, Ms. Carson met with the county attorney and went over some processes for the election. He sent us some drafts to look over. So once that process is, I guess, nailed down and approved, I'm not sure it's something that's got to go to the board, but probably at least approved by the county manager, then we will proceed with the election.
So y'all haven't gotten to that point yet?
No, sir, we have not. No, we have not selected or put out for nominations or anything like that. So we're just working through the process.
Well, fortunately, we have addressed the situation. We have an able member to serve and stay it until that process works its way through. So very glad to have you on board. Okay, the fifth item. Rodney Pirkle request for civil service appeal and HR response. Mr. Miles.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, we have received a letter response from Pat Carson as Director of Personnel Services, which I believe has been forwarded to each of you dated August 30. And in that response, Ms. Carson addresses the concerns that were raised in this particular matter, and her decision on behalf of HR is that this board does not have jurisdiction to hear Mr. Pirkle's appeal for two primary reasons. The first being that he was still classified as a probationary employee, and that if he alleges as a probationary employee, the second reason being if he alleges as a probationary employee that he was discriminated against based on political motivation or improper political motivation, that he has a remedy under both state and federal law, and that would be outside the jurisdiction of this particular board. And so based upon that, I believe that this board has, I think, two choices, and you would need to probably take action one way or the other. The first would be to accept the decision of Ms. Carson that he is ineligible for an appeal, in which case Mr. Pirkle would have the right to obviously pursue his remedies in state and federal court if he so chooses. One of the things that could happen as a result of that is a state or federal court could potentially remand it to this board for factual findings as to whether or not there was evidence of political discrimination or not. That would be totally discretionary in the judge's position. The second thing that this board could do would be to choose to reject Ms. Carson's determination and to hold a hearing. Obviously, the county would contest that and take and advocate its position probably subsequently in Superior Court, because as y'all are aware, either side has the right to appeal any decision of this board to the Superior Court. So I believe those are your options. I'll be glad to address any questions that the board might have.
Board members, what's any thoughts?
Seems like it's out of our hands right now. And I think we're right there and accept this person's reason.
Mr. Perry, you got any comments?
No, I would select that motion.
Did you put that in a form of a motion?
I will. That's my motion. Accept the information we have from Ms. Pat Carson concerning.
That this board does not have jurisdiction to hear his appeal for the reasons set forth in her letter of August 30, just to make the motion clear.
Okay. You second that, Mr. Pierre?
Yes, sir.
There's a motion on the floor and a second that we accept Ms. Carson's
determination
as to her letter, that we do not have the power to hear it. There are other means which can be in fine remedy. All those in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion's unanimous. Item 6 on the agenda. You still there, Mr. Blanchard?
Yes, sir.
We are, we were extremely blessed to have you as a board member. You did a great job while you were here. I believe you were fair in all of your decisions. And the board wanted to honor you, and so therefore we have a resolution drawn up, and I'm going to read it. It's a resolution of appreciation and honor of John Blanchard. Whereas John Blanchard has served ably as a member of the Forsyth County Civil Service Board since September 22, 2003. Whereas John Blanchard has been duly elected to 3 terms in office as the employee representative on the Forsyth County Civil Service Board. Whereas John Blanchard has served with honor and distinction through August 31, 2012, when he resigned due to moving out of Forsyth County. Whereas John Blanchard has substantially contributed to the Civil Service Board's efforts to arrive at fair, impartial decisions on appeals for the benefit of Forsyth County employees, Forsyth County management, and the public. Whereas John Blanchard has exemplified the Civil Service Board motto of seeking truth, justice, and the American way. And whereas John Blanchard has always greeted everyone with a warm smile and a cheerful countenance, making serving with him a pleasure. Now therefore be it hereby resolved by the Forsyth County Civil Service Board that the board extends its deepest appreciation to John Blanchard for his excellent service as a member of this board. So resolved, this 13th day of September 2012, this document will be signed by myself as chairman, Dr. Howell as vice chairman, and Mr. Tim Peary as member, and it'll be attested by our clerk, Charity Clark, and our hearing officer, Dana Miles. Congratulations, John, and we appreciate everything you've done for us.
Well, man, thank you very much. You really make me miss it.
We miss you.
Been around you people, that's for sure.
We will sign this, and we will get a copy mailed to you. Might even put it in a little frame.
Well, already be done.
So
I tell you, I really appreciate it. Like I say, I miss being with everybody there.
Well, you come by and visit us when you come back down here.
I sure will.
We'll see you later.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right,
bye-bye.
Lord, Ms. Smith, you'll need a motion to adopt that resolution.
Okay. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I have a motion that we adopt this resolution.
I make that motion.
There's a motion and a second to adopt the resolution. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. The motion carries unanimously, and we will get this signed and mailed to him. Board, do you see any reason that we should go into executive session? Mr. Mott?
None that I'm aware of.
Okay. Do I hear a motion to adjourn?
No.
Okay.
I will do that. As soon as we adjourn, I'll make sure I get your signature on the 3 minutes. Versions of the minutes, so I'll pass those
around. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Is there anything else? Motion to adjourn?
Second.
All in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Motion's unanimous. We're adjourned. Should we all sign this for the same thing?
Yeah.
Those are just extras. August 16th. That's good. Got them all. Awesome.
Thank you. Yeah, everything signed? You gonna take that in and out? You gonna let her make a copy of it first? What do you want to do?
Yeah. Do you want to take it? I'll make a couple copies.
Okay. I'll be glad to contribute towards the cost to get framed or pay for that. That's happy to do that. Mr. Blanchard did a great job.
You got a question?
Gentlemen, pleasure. I want to have the seminar.
Oh, that's nice. Continuing education. Yeah, yeah. That's fun.
Well, enjoy yourself. Sure.
Thank you. See you. Stay
safe.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir.
I'm sure it's right here.